All right, so now we know how read.table works, and that paves our way to learning some shortcuts. The file we loaded into R, the previous lesson, is a CSV file. It is a simple text document in which the values are separated by commas. CSV files are extremely common, so R's brainy developers have given us a shortcut function with which to load them faster. This function is from the read.table family and it's called read.csv. Read.csv takes fewer arguments than read.table because its defaults are set in a very convenient way. Headers are set to true and separators are set to a comma. All we need to do in order to read a table is pass the name of the file and specify whether we want our strings to be factors or not. Sweet! Apart from comma separated, values in a text data file can be separated by tabs. These types of documents are called tab-delimited files. And just as CSVs, there is a read.table shortcut to reading them called read.delim. Now what's happening behind the scenes here is that the separator argument is set to \t, header is again true, and a bunch of other useful arguments are set to default to their most commonly used values. Now, just before we wrap this up, I want to mention a few important things. First, for those of you in Europe or anywhere else in the world where the notation for the decimal is a comma, and therefore CSV files don't really work for you, there is a read.csv2 function designed to deal with this problem. It reads CSV files with a semicolon as a separator. The same goes for read.delim, which also has a version 2 with the exact same purpose. Second, often, data files from external sources come with additional text, either as an introduction or as a sign-off, which will only cause havoc in your data if you end up importing it. Therefore, it is excellent that we can tell R to completely ignore the first few lines of a text in our data file. If you want to restrict where R stops reading the data file, you can tell it to read a precise number of rows with the Nrow argument. For example, our Pokemon data is way too large, and I may only be interested in the first 100 Pokemon. If I set Nrow to 100, this is exactly what I will get. Pay attention to what happened here. The header doesn't count towards the number of rows specified. Nrow stands for rows of observations. Okay, let's break it off here. Super, super good job, everyone. The next lesson will be very short and it will complete the data import-export circle. We will be talking about exporting data. See you there, and may the force be with you.
For more videos like this one, please subscribe.